Please join me in thanking VFW Post 6519, all current members and former members of the military, and members of the class of 2020 who have committed to protect this great country that we live in. As we honor our beautiful country, please join me in celebrating our freedom, all members of our military, and our band in playing of our national anthem. Thank you, VFW. We appreciate and honor you for all that you do. Now please welcome our honorarians, Carly Piernot and Kenneth Leach, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Each year, we celebrate the joy and beauty of our school by showcasing our seniors singing to their classmates, families, and friends. Please welcome the senior members of our Chardon Choir as they perform the Chardon High School's alma mater. When the alma mater is complete, the choir will be singing and performing their vocal selections for the class of 2020.
Oh, hail to thee, our Chardon High, our love for you shall never die. Memories that to us are dear will last forever through the years. Walls around us blessed will be forever in eternity.
Take 1,000.
Stand in the light and be seen as we are. Didn't I tell you I hear what you say?
Every day.
It is my honor to welcome you all to the 147th commencement exercise of Chardon High School. Today, I welcome members of the Chardon Board of Education, our commencement speaker, Dr. Michael P. Hanlon, Jr., Superintendent of Chardon Local Schools, our district administration, faculty members of Chardon Schools, parents, families, friends, guests of our graduates, and of course, the class of 2020. Today, we celebrate our graduates. Exactly 2 months ago today, our world paused. Everything that we knew, experienced, and prepared for felt frozen in time. Every corner of industry and every person connected to it directly and indirectly had to learn how to operate life within new boundaries. Within that was you. The class of 2020 across the world were impacted by an invisible virus that shook everything that districts prepared for and looked forward to. All year, I have spoken at length about how we choose our response to any event, and this one is tough. Today's celebration, the class of 2020, is as genuine as they are. Watching this commencement in its entirety allows you to see our graduates as active participants of our commencement story. Their commencement follows the treasured history of our alumni. In a similar tone, we take this time now at graduation to recognize our golden anniversary of our Chardon alumni. If you look at the last page of your program that you received on the day of May 16th, you will note the graduates of class of 1970 listed. Chardon has a strong and rich history. We honor and celebrate the history by recognizing the golden anniversary of our alumni. Tradition never graduates. All of our graduates celebrate your story, just as you celebrate our students who celebrate their commencement today. Please join me in giving the members of the class of 1970 a round of applause. As a proud graduate, I stand with all alum in celebrating the accomplishments and contributions to our community. The definition of commencement has two parts. There is the traditional use of the word, a ceremony in which degrees or diplomas are conferred, and then there's a second part of the definition, which is a beginning or a start. Today we are celebrating both. The first part of our commencement for the class of 2020 took place on May 16th during the 12-hour tour through the beauty of the student parking lot, which looked the same to the class of 1970, and it led you on a four-part journey from the student lots to an elementary school next to that lot to see familiar faces and reminisce cherished memories of your primary years. Your journey continued as you moved through Chardon High School, a key foundation of your growth. You were reminded how much you missed your teachers in person, laughing at Mr. Snyder's jokes, and illegally parking in the rolling hills of the teacher lots. Some of you might have even glanced one last time at Mrs. Tasnick's room where you worked overtime from 2:40 to 3:30 because of tardies. And your tour extended to the present day, seeing the athletic complex, running on the track, competing on Chardon Memorial Field, and being a proud member of the Chardon Crazies. Then your eyes became blinded by the light as you entered your commencement. There, you saw the glistening of my happiness and knew you were ready to graduate. You stepped out of your car, heard your name read, were recorded by GTV, photographed by Pastor Photography, and were congratulated by our Board of Education, Dr. Hanlon, and then Dr. Klein. You officially crossed the threshold of commencement into your new beginning. Instead of focusing on something that you have not witnessed on this big screen yet, I would like to focus on the second part, stage four, your new beginning and the power of love. The students at Chardon High School know me very well. They know that I'm a man of many words, but I truly will make them to the point today. The students know when there is a microphone nearby that I can take a statement and turn it into a paragraph. But what they also know is how much I care for them and how much I love them. They know my heart. I truly stand before you so unbelievably proud of your accomplishments. I cannot express in simple words what you mean to me. You've accomplished so many tasks, and you are leaders of Chardon High School. You are resilient, compassionate, hilarious, and so very talented. And you matter. You have learned. You have experienced and served in so many ways as a servant leader in our school, and I couldn't be more proud than I am on this day. I have one more lesson for you, a lesson prior to your commencement, a lesson on love. Graduates, you don't ever have to do anything sensational in order to love people or to have people love you. I have discovered early on in life that the real drama is never meant to be on center stage or in the spotlight. In fact, it has very little to do with IQs and honors outside the fancies of life. What ultimately nourishes your soul is knowing the fact that you can be trusted, that you never have to fear the truth, and that the foundation of your very being is put forward into every action that will nourish your goodness. Graduates, you are so gifted and talented. Your class emulates success academically, athletically, socially, and within our community. I could speak all of you individually sharing your goodness, but your one request was to not to turn this into the week in reflection. But really, what is goodness without sharing? Your parents and teachers have grown and watched you daily, and we are so proud of your accomplishments. Many people state that you are the future. You're way more than that. You are the strength of today, and I am so proud of you. Thank you. I'd like to introduce Dr. Michael P. Hanlon, Jr. as your commencement speaker. Dr. Michael P. Hanlon has served as the superintendent of Chardon Local School District for the past 7 years. I'm proud to share that on his first day on the job, he met a young and exciting young administrator that he hired. And over the last 7 years, Dr. Hanlon has collaborated with community members, teachers, staff, parents, and students to maximize on resources while maintaining focus on the district's mission statement. Prior to his work in our district, Dr. Hanlon served as superintendent of Painesville City Schools for 15 years. He was only one of two people in history to have served as superintendent in both of these school districts. Dr. Hanlon began his career in education as an elementary school teacher in the Mentor Schools District. He is a passionate supporter of education, not only in our district, but in our entire state, and he absolutely loves students. His vision and energy has guided us through so many positive initiatives. Outside of his daily responsibilities in the district, Dr. Hanlon serves on legal committees with the Buckeye Association of School Administrators, collaborates with leaders across the state of Ohio, and he is involved in the Alliance for Higher Quality of Education. In addition to his work with schools and students, he's an avid athlete, competing in several marathons and running races throughout the year, and continue to play and referee hockey for leagues in Northeast Ohio. I am proud to work collaboratively with Dr. Hanlon and to call him my friend. Thank you, Dr. Hanlon, for addressing our students as they transition to college, the military, and their career. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Hanlon.
A virtual welcome to our graduates, Board of Education members, distinguished faculty, and members of our school community, as we celebrate the commencement exercises for the class of 2020 from Chardon High School. I was honored when Mr. Murray asked me to speak to the class today as we celebrate your accomplishments, both individually and collectively. Honestly, this is unlike any commencement I have ever participated in during my 22 years as a school district superintendent. I've never presented an address solely to a camera and been unable to experience the feeling that comes with a day of great accomplishment like today. The happiness, the excitement, the nervous energy, and the celebration, and so many more feelings as you move forward from Chardon High School. As I thought about my remarks for today, it would have been easy to do the traditional speech and thank your teachers, administrators, families, and our great community for their unwavering support and commitment to both you and the mission of our school district, to give you a pat on the back and send you on your way. While those are certainly very accurate statements, today isn't quite so easy. So I'm going to tear that speech up and do something a little different. The global pandemic shut down our schools on March 16, 2020. Things changed in the blink of an eye. You've missed out on a great many of the traditions that make high school a memorable time in our lives. We need to acknowledge that together. And I also want you to know that we missed you as well. So take a walk with me for a moment. We missed you in our classrooms, where you interacted daily with outstanding teachers to help us achieve our mission, high achievement for all students, where learning is our most important work. We missed you in our hallways, where you brought excitement, vitality, and a sense of Chardon pride every day. We missed you here in our gymnasium, where the Chardon crazies could always be counted on to bring school spirit like no other. We missed you in our band and choir rooms and on the stage, where our fine and performing arts programs continually reached new heights in performances. We missed you here in our cafeteria, where High Five Friday was always welcome. We missed you on our athletic fields of play, where Topper Up was more than something that you say. It was a deep personal commitment between our student athletes, our boosters, and our fans. We missed you here, where community service is more than something you put on a transcript. Quite simply, it's the right thing to do. We missed you here because you are the heart of Chardon High School. It's understandable to look at this spring and the conclusion of your senior year in terms of loss. I guess it all has to do with perspective in this moment. I'm going to challenge you to look at it a little differently and consider the opportunities that you were offered during this time. You had the opportunity to broaden your paradigm of heroes to include healthcare and pharmacy workers, educators, truck drivers, mail carriers, and grocery store workers. You connected with your family and people close to you in ways that didn't always come from a device. I'm sure mostly for the better, but I know it could have been challenging as well during this time. Perhaps you gained a perspective on our larger role in life, which is to connect with people on a human level with greater empathy. And you learned to support each other by doing the little things that might go unseen, but they matter, and possibly you made a difference when someone needed it most. Perhaps you developed a new skill or a passion that would have gone unnoticed as a result of the gift of time that you have been given. These don't replace the experiences that you missed by any stretch. They were simply different experiences. Timothy Kite is well known for his work with Urban Meyer and the Ohio State football team. Recently, he said, defining moments are situations where your path through life is challenged by adversity. You are not defined by this situation. You are defined by how you respond. Today, and this is a defining moment, how you respond means everything. This class of 2020 is remarkable in so many ways. Academically, artistically, athletically, and so many more. Over the past few months, I was given the gift of seeing things from a different perspective. My hope is that you see what I saw from my point of view and choose to respond in a way that helps you to continue to grow as a person. I saw so many celebrations of our senior class and our senior spotlights on social media. The responses from staff and community members to those posts were incredible and probably meant more to you coming from different corners of your life where you least expected it. These provided constant reminders of the achievements of our seniors. I saw community partners coming together to plant Class of 2020 celebratory signs in your front yards in recognition of your many accomplishments. That's why it's important to remember where you are from. Pride, tradition, and community support flow freely here, and our community rallied around you. I saw your building administrators, community leaders, and organizations thinking outside of the box to find a way for you to still cross a stage that is so important so that they could recognize your achievement in person. Along with that, I experienced student leadership from dedicated class officers and class members that teamed up with Chardon High School administrators and staff members to plan the celebration experience of your accomplishments. I saw amazing examples of learning and collaboration that probably would not have occurred in a typical school setting, but they are likely to now become the norm in how we work and go to school in the future. Perhaps you are the pioneers that we are going to look back on one day, who literally changed in the blink of an eye how schools functioned today and how they are likely to function in the future. Maybe you showed everyone that learning can occur anywhere and anytime. I saw new ways of demonstrating community service. The recognition of the projects and your contributions within our community have been significant. There were incredible stories of how you stepped up and made a difference to senior citizens, young children, and important community causes that were certainly heartwarming. I guess it's all a matter of perspective. Excuse me. As I reflect on my own high school graduation now 40 years ago, almost to the day, our country was going through a different but very significant crisis. We were embattled in a Cold War with the then Soviet Union, our country's economy was in upheaval, and there were significant natural disasters that caused significant damage in our country. The outlook was certainly bleak, and people wondered if we would emerge strong as a nation again. In some ways, it was very much the same feeling as we have today. It was also 40 years ago today that a team of amateur, mostly college hockey players did the unthinkable by winning the Olympic gold medal in men's ice hockey. En route to the gold medal game, they defeated the team from the Soviet Union, arguably at that time the best team in the world, composed of today what would be considered professional hockey players. The gold medal victory became known as the Miracle on Ice and galvanized our country in its resurgence. Team USA coach Herb Brooks offered an often quoted opening to his important locker room speech before the Soviet game. It's a quote that has made a tremendous impact on me since 1980, and I refer to it often over my many years. Great moments are born from great opportunity. That is exactly what faces you right now, a great opportunity. It is why we focus on the four E's of enrollment, employment, enlistment, and entrepreneurship at Chardon High School. You are ready to move forward and explore one or more of these and leverage the opportunity before you. As you consider that opportunity, you may be a bit concerned, understandably, that the path that you thought had been mapped out for you seems a little less certain today than it did even 2 months ago. Whether it is furthering your education, entering the world of work, enlisting in the military, or considering your own business opportunity, recent events may cause you to question that path and feel like the ground underneath you is just a little less stable than you thought it was originally. Well, here's the secret. The fact is that everyone has faced an uncertain path in life. There is a difference between the ideal path that we set out for ourselves that exists often only in our minds and that jagged path that everyone actually experiences in life. We only see success in people after they have become successful and the polish is on the apple. The truth is that very few people follow that straight line path from today to what they define as success. Most of us experience a jagged path that twists and turns, that serves to mold us into the success that we desire. Embrace that jagged path It will make you stronger and more resilient. We've heard the phrase, "We are living in unprecedented times," used frequently in the past 2 months. Honestly, I don't tend to agree with that characterization. There's a great video out there where Simon Sinek, a leadership specialist, outlines just a few of the disruptions that have changed the way we do things. The internet, Uber, Starbucks. This current disruption is more sudden and pronounced than those, but it is not without precedent. Those that take advantage of the opportunity to engage the disruption and think differently about how we will do things in the future will be the ones that thrive and succeed. Class of 2020, I'm firm in my resolve and belief that you are prepared to do just that, to think differently about how we will work, how we'll learn, how we will play, and live to be the leaders of the world that will look different from what it did before. Class of 2020, we are very proud of everything that you've accomplished, and we wish you nothing but the very best in the future. My congratulations to you.
Thank you, Dr. Hanlon, for your passion, creativity, and commitment to serve all of our students. And now, it is my pleasure to introduce our valedictorians and salutatorian, who will share with us a quote that has influenced their lives. We will begin with Gwendolyn Avery.
Hi, my name is Gwen Avery, and my quote is from the Book of Psalm, chapter 16, verse 8. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken.
Hello, my name is Sarah Bennett, and my quote is for the junior class. Junior girls, I'm expecting a powder puff rematch when this is all over.
Hi, my name is Whitney Bourne, and my quote is from the Book of Proverbs, verse 3, 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him and he will lead your path straight.
Chris Carter, don't make the same mistake once. Danny Duncan.
Natalie Dumb, normality is a paved road. It's comfortable to walk, but no flowers grow. Vincent Van Gogh.
Hi, my name is Lauren Dvorak, and my quote is, whether you say I can or I can't, you're right either way, from Jordan Belford.
Hello, my name is Mitchell Owaska, and my quote is, the things you do for yourself are gone when you are gone, but the things you do for others remain as your legacy, by Kalu Nundukwe Kalu.
Hi, my name is Alyssa Fisher, and my quote is, enjoy the little things, for one day you may look back and realize they were the big things. Robert Brault.
Hi, my name is Natalie Fullerman, and my quote is, it's kind of fun to do the impossible. Walt Disney.
Hi, I'm Jenna Goodwin, and my quote is, the most important thing is to enjoy your life, to be happy. It's all that matters. Audrey Hepburn.
Hi, I'm Megan McCartney. My quote is, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Eleanor Roosevelt.
My name is Kaylee Malloy, and my quote is, be who God meant you to be, and you will set the world on fire.
Hi, my name is Hannah Means, and my quote is, for me, education was power. Michelle Obama.
Hi, I'm Claire Myroff, and as the ancient Greek philosopher Socrates once said, high school is like toilet paper. You only miss it when it's gone.
I'm Elizabeth Love, and as the Bible says in Ecclesiastes 10:2, a wise man's heart inclines him to the right, but a fool's to the left.
Hi, I'm Marissa Organischek. We must be willing to let go of the life we plan so as to have the life that is waiting for us. So, Joseph Campbell.
Hi, I'm Maya Peterson. I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Maya Angelou.
Hi, I'm Lauren Phillips, and we didn't realize we were making memories. We just knew we were having fun. A.A. Milne.
Hi, I'm Carly Piernot, and my quote is, sometimes you will never know the value of a moment until it becomes a memory.
Hi, my name is Noah Rozek, and my quote is, you can't heal in the same environment you got sick in.
Hi, my name is Marissa Serbo, and my quote is, keep your face always towards the sunshine, and shadows will fall behind you.
My name is Grace Powell, and I chose the quote, "You can't climb the ladder of success with your hands in your pockets," by Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Mila Stropke. If we wait until we're ready, we'll be waiting the rest of our lives. Lemony Snicket.
Jude Teddy. If a man does not have sauce, then he is lost. But, the same man can get lost in the sauce. Gucci Mane.
Allison Smirnell. I'm ready to face any challenges that might be foolish enough to face me. Dwight K. Schrute.
Please welcome the Class of 2020 Senior Class Officers Grace Powell, Carly Piernot, and Marissa Serbo, who will address their classmates.
Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Forrest Gump was pretty on point with this. Our lives are far from ideal right now. Who would have thought we'd have to record our commencement speech? But like all aspects in life, we can choose how we react. And who doesn't want to be sweet like a box of chocolates? At times, it seems like our class has always picked the worst piece of chocolate. Each new school year, we experienced new changes. However, we always found a way to adapt.
Class of 2020, we are unique. Throughout our time at Chardon, many changes have occurred that seemed inconvenient when they originated. From the discontinuation of the Hershey trip, to a new high school block schedule, to a premature end of our senior year, it would have been so easy to fixate on the negatives. However, the amount of opportunities and positive experiences we have been granted easily surpasses these so-called disadvantages. It's all about perspective. Who didn't love our trip to Chicago and getting to sleep in every Wednesday? Recently, we've also gained a new understanding of how important it is to support each other, along with a substantial lesson in thinking outside the box. Tradition is being thrown out the window, yet in a way, it isn't. We're still finding the best ways to come together. The love and support from our community and families alike is stronger than ever, and really, that's more than any of us could ever ask for. We have handled our situation with levels of maturity and dignity that most wouldn't believe to be possible within a group of 17 and 18-year-olds. But I'm not surprised at all. We are strong. We are Chardon.
Our lives are defined by two dates with a dash in the middle. Like books supported by bookends, our lives are determined by the pages in between. In our case, the pages are even more important due to the fact that our high school experience never reached its end date. Within these pages, the memories, friendships, and even failures create the story. We may not be able to change the chapters written about our time at Chardon High, but we can control the next chapters of our lives. Our futures are more uncertain now than ever, but this experience will shape what we write into existence. For example, without this incident, we may not have learned the importance of staying connected, both to our teachers and to our peers. These past couple months have only reinforced the fact that we will always have a support system behind us. Our teachers have spent countless hours preparing us for the future. It's up to us to use what they've taught us, both in academics and in life. Chardon may have built each individual a strong foundation for success, but only you yourself can determine what to do with it. So, class of 2020, it's up to us to make the most of the dash.
As Forrest wisely said, life is full of surprises. We get the opportunity to choose our path in life, but sometimes life can throw a curveball. It's our job to adapt and maybe even embrace these times. We have had many obstacles these past couple years, but each challenge is a lesson. But look at us now, we are graduating, not all together on mentor stage, but all together in spirit, as they say. Seniors, I can't wait to see how all of us succeed in the next chapters of our lives. Good luck to you all, thank you.
Thank you, girls. And for the record, I do like dark chocolate. And don't you worry, you will never be forgotten for your legacy at Chardon High School. Now, graduates, this is the moment you've been waiting for. Your educational life has called you to this moment. Today is the day that all of your hard work will lead you to the beginning of your four E's: enrollment into college, enlistment into the armed forces, employment within a career, or working towards becoming an entrepreneur. This is the first of many finish lines that will lead you to a whole new race. And now please welcome our board president, Madeline Horvath.
We are very pleased to honor this class, which has had to deal with such special loss this year. On behalf of the faculty and the administration of Chardon High School, I certify that these members of the class of 2020 qualify for graduation by having successfully completed all of the requirements of the Ohio Department of Education and have met the standards set forth by the Chardon Local Schools Board of Education.
Generally, it is during this time that I ask members of the audience to refrain from calling out or shouting during the recognition of our graduates. I usually say something like, everyone has come to celebrate their child's accomplishment and they deserve to hear their name. Thank you for being mindful of this and our students and our families. Please hold all your applause until the last, et cetera, et cetera. But today, while you're at home, eating your popcorn, sing, applause, dance, make a TikTok, celebrate the class of 2020 in the company of your family. Gwendolyn Ruth Avery. Hannah Hudson Means. Natalie Ann Dumb. Congrats. Kaylee Emma Malloy. Elizabeth Christina Love. Kenneth Thomas Leach. Maya Marie Peterson. Marissa Carolyn Serbo. Carly Elizabeth Piernot. Allison Nicole Smirdell. Jenna Marie Goodwin. Mila Grace Stropke. Congratulations. Mitchell Anderson Iwaska. Whitney Rebecca Bourne. Congratulations. Sarah Grace Bennett. Congratulations. Alyssa Christine Fisher. Marissa May Organischek. Natalie Regina Fullerman. Lauren Amelia Dvork. Megan Catherine McCartney. Christopher Michael Carter Jr. Claire Lemmerman Myroff. Noelle Elizabeth Rosick. Grace Catherine Powell. Jude Owen Taddy. Lauren Elise Phillips.
Kayla Elizabeth Allen. Harry Lee Allen the Fourth.
Congratulations.
Charles Evan Baker. Sophia Maria Alexandru. Samuel Hunter Adams. Alexis Marie Arnold.
Audrey Elizabeth Adamick. Leah Nicole Baker. Nicholas Michael Becker. Olivia K. Adkins. Kirsten Adriana Beard. Mackenzie Renee Berry. Madison Nicole Berry. Nathan Patrick Albers.
Hannah Rose Berman. Logan Jacob Bjornholm. Alexandra Lee Bojack. Seth James Boswell. Congratulations, Seth. Kylie Marie Brown. Deshaun Michael Bowman. Madison Elizabeth Brakefield. Congratulations, Madison. Dalton Christopher Boyer. Congratulations. Ryan Lawson Blumel. Congratulations. Emma Rose Bile. Congratulations.
Grace Elizabeth Burneau. John Martin Bresnay. Nicholas Jeffrey Bross. Gracie Helena Bright. Joshua Lee Campbell. Isabella Sky Byrne. Elise Ann Shalette. Kara Ann Connolly. Congratulations. Marcus Anton Chabi. Nicholas Anthony Calabrese. Mitchell Scott Cormia. Edward Thomas Bouzagon. Sarah Elizabeth Conway. Ethan Walter Beener. Chloe Marie Budd. Anne Elizabeth Sizak. Allison Diane Eves. Nolan Patrick Ellis. Gabrielle Ray Cross. Colin Jeffrey Downs. Emma Grace Davis. Kelly Ray Dawson. Mason Edward Dannison. John Forrest Ellington. John William Dinko. Dylan Charles Cox. Elizabeth Rose Evans. Dylan James Dwyer. Jacob Michael Eleftherio. Elizabeth Marie Darling. Grace Christine Gasper. Logan Renee Foster. Brennan David Farina. Flora Grace Frieden. Chloe Michelle Geis. Emma Jolene Fulton. Cooper Lucas Farrow. Lane Stuart Fearman. Logan Madison Felger. Thomas Franklin Fowle. Terry John Finger. Brittany Marie Ferraro. Jacob Maxwell Garrett. Robert Charles Frank. Nathan Ryan Griffin. Dylan Anthony Grebe.
Congratulations, Steph.
Serena Nicole Gromack. Jarrett Ryan Hall. Jacob Matthew Hamulak. Alexis McKenna Hatridge. Molly Catherine Marie Googe. Jacob Philip Grantham. Caitlin Ann Goodrich. Mikhail Ajani Hall. Mia Juliet Gumpf. Congratulations.
Aiden Alexander Gray. Elizabeth Catherine Gray. Logan Daniel Gillis.
Caitlin Paige Hansacker. Aiden Christopher Jernasek. Stephen Douglas Jackson. Julia Sadie Hauser. Thomas Gregory Yonke. Madeline Elaine Hauser. Samantha Nicole Hess. Alexis Ray Herman. Kendra Kathleen Holmes. Hannah Mae Holbert.
Congratulations.
Sophia Maylin Koo. Justin Maxwell Kluter. Diva Marie Kruger. Tucker James Keeney. Noah Dennis Keeney.
Congratulations.
Caleb John Kelly. Dylan Joseph Koyman. Mason William Koyman. Joshua Jared Kearns. Callie Ann Landes. Quinn Haylett Leskovic. Madeline Lorraine McDonald. Alexandria Rose Lavo. Isabel Anna Marinchak. Congratulations. Lauren Barbara Lodato. Annabelle May Leapart. William Douglas Mazurek. Tori Alize Lowe. Aiden Kenneth McCaskill. Mackenzie Ann May. Lucia Carolyn Muick. Zachary William Mothersbaugh.
Congratulations.
Meredith Ann McKeon.
Good to go.
John Patrick Mullally.
McCray Casey Metz.
Congratulations.
Elijah Sheldon Morris.
Congratulations.
Zachary Robert Morrison.
Congratulations.
Bridget Hope Morgan. Kyle David Nelson.
Congratulations.
Elliot David Miller.
Congratulations.
Hannah Christina Mitchell.
Ashley Rose Patterson. Noah Paul Wesley Orwick. Kristen Elise Najelski. Isaac Jacob Norris. Dominic Joseph Peters.
Congratulations.
Isabella Nicole Patty. Cody Douglas Peterson. Hallie Ray Parrish. Catherine Elizabeth Parr. Brian Callagher Parker. Caitlin Brooke Nimmo.
Matthew James Reminder.
Congratulations.
Matthew Allen Pickup.
Congratulations.
Cameron Michael Rypel. Haley Elizabeth Richard. Hannah Delane Russ. Victor Emmanuel Roses. Ryan Edmund Pollock. Cassidy Lynn Robinson. Jaden Ryan Sanchez. Hannah Kelly Romanoff. Mercedes Isabella Santa Maria.
Sarah Elizabeth Schmouder. Morgan Karen Sitters. Katarina Rose Schultz. Lucas William Semler. Teresa Marie Schneider. Melanie Grace Schaefer. Christopher Andrew Shea. Elise Kennedy Silipini. Luke Daniel Shuddy. Congratulations.
Madeline Nicole Snow. John Michael Schumann. Bailey James Sylvia.
Cecilia Elizabeth Stansberry. Terry Allen Spielman III. Brandon Samuel Soar. Olivia Lynn Stern. Kathleen Carol Szynski. Allison Elizabeth Sutton. Cameron James Strichko. Elena Grace Sudnick. Joseph Paul Sankrant. Matthew Jacob Talarczyk.
Michaela Elise Tepley. Daniel Charles Thomas. Dylan Michael Thomas. Nicholas Michael Tilton. Gina Claire Terranova. Congratulations.
Joseph Louis Tribasano. Mario Aaron Trillo. Noah Clayton Joel Toscano. Ashley Nicole Tice. Isabella Rose Vian. Jacob Raymond Batty.
Maximus Aurelius Vuaclia. Jocelyn May Williams. Cody Edward Wills.
Congratulations.
Robert John Winters Jr. Katie Marie Whiting. Maxwell Joseph McBride. Chloe Marie Sukrajcik. Joseph Paul Zimmerer. Zachary James Yoger. Bradley James Yoger. Keaton James Ziegenfuss. Woo! Brianna Lee Zuzak. Bradley Gibson Warburton. Jonah William Zeiger. Mackenzie Lee Zajakowski. McKenna Ann Zugan.
Angel Rose Chapman. Kelly Margaret Hall. Courtney Holmes. Jonathan Ryan Jordan. William Alexander Kurtz. Robert Stone Mason. Kyle Christopher Menmuir. Joseph Charles Niederst. Isabella Maria Ritosa. Anna Mackenzie Soule. Kyle Joseph Toth. Tonzai Bunag. Virginia Katidi. Sarisa Tadzupan. Congratulations. Let us give the class of 2020 a round of applause. So in the midst of the community of Chardon High School, which has always honored excellence, my hope for you is that you will take good care of that part of you, that invisible part where your best dreams come from, that part that always helps you feel for others and allows you to appreciate your life and encourages you to give thanks for the blessings in your life, because that's what matters the most in this world. Congratulations, class of 2020. We wish you many blessings, and we thank you for sharing this day with us. Congratulations.